Okay. So ladies and gentlemen, again, to approach the limit when x approaches, as x approaches from negative 1. Remember, this is a piecewise function. So this graph could look like exactly what we just wrote a picture of, right? It could look just like that. So when evaluating the limit, obviously the limit negative 1, we know we have to evaluate for this function. So that's just going to be negative 1 plus 1, which equals 0. Correct? However, here's the issue. When we look at as x approaches 0, 0 is kind of the defining point where we change from one function to the next. Correct? We know that this function, as far as evaluating for the function, this is where 0 is a value, and 0 is not a value for here. But this is the point where the function kind of changes. And let's kind of just take a look at, you know, some options of what this graph could look like. X plus 1 and x plus 1 is less than 0. So you know, we could have something that's going to be like that. And we could either have them connected, or there could be a jump, and they could not be connected, right? Now, obviously, some of you might be able to look at this and be able to determine that in your head, if they're connected or not. But the whole point is, what if you're given a graph? What if you're given a graph that you can't visualize what the graph looks like? And hint, hint, that's probably what you're going to be given. It's something where you're not going to be able to visualize what the graph looks like, or you're not going to be able to graph it. So how are we going to determine if my values at 0 are going to be continuous or not continuous? So what we need to do when we're evaluating a piecewise function at this kind of breakpoint is to evaluate the limit as x approaches 0 from the negative side of f of x, and the limit as x approaches from the positive side of f of x. If we find the value from the left side and from the right side is equivalent, then the function is continuous. Does that kind of make sense? Now, if you look at this piecewise function, if we're, you know, if this function is from the left and this function is from the right, so if I want to evaluate for f of 0 from the left, I'm going to have to use this function. Would everybody agree? If I'm going to evaluate from the right-hand side, I'm going to be using this quadratic function, because that's the one that goes to the right of f of 0. So when evaluating 0 from the negative, you're not making negative 0. 0 is not positive or negative. You're just plugging in 0 into the appropriate function, which from the left is going to be this function, because these are all values that are left of 0. So I just plug in 0 plus 1. And then here, I plug in 0 positive. It's going to be in for there. So that's going to be 0 squared plus 1. And you guys can see from the left and from the right-hand side, the limit is equal. Correct? Since the limit is equal from the left-hand side and the right-hand side, we now know that this limit exists, right? Which is just 1. So the graph looks like this. That's what the graph, and you guys, obviously, if you were to graph these two, you know that x squared plus 1 is right there and there. So that's what the graph looks like. So this graph is a piecewise function, but it's continuous. OK? Because not all piecewise functions are going to be discontinuous.